Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Afif Harimi Muhammad Azam and my manage number is 1182059. Today, I would like to present about cancer analysis of SBC Corporation Berhad. So, we go first to the brief introduction of SBC Corporation Berhad. SBC Corporation was founded in 1954, which is based in Kuala Lumpur. It is an investment company that is involved in property, investment and development activities. From years to years, SBC Corporation has established itself as Malaysia's leading construction and development business by embracing technical advancement and innovative construction processes. Now, let's start the cancer analysis of SBC Corporation Berhad. First of all, we look at the current earnings of SBC Corp. In general, we can see that the quarterly performance of SBC Corp fluctuated. The highest revenue recorded was in the first quarter of 2020. Meanwhile, the highest profit recorded was in the second quarter of 2020. If we compare the last two quarterly performance, we can see that there is a decline in the profit, but the revenue shows a rising trend. However, the profit margin illustrates a huge decrease, so we can assume that the current earnings of SBC Corp is not too good. Next, for the annual earnings growth, the pattern also fluctuated. In March 2020, SBC Corp recorded the highest revenue since 2012 with RM170.2 million. The highest profit gain was in 2014 with RM35 million. However, the revenue in 2021 shows a major drop in compared to the last year and as well as the profit after tax. Meanwhile, the profit margin shows a slight improvement. In short, we can conclude that the annual earnings growth of SBC Corp is still low and shows a decline in terms of revenue and profit after tax. In terms of news or new management, SBC Corp doesn't have any big announcement that can boost the stock price of SBC Corp. Most of the announcement regarding the quarterly report, which they delay the release date of the quarterly report for the two quarters in a row. Another news regarding SBC Corp is about the latest update of the agreement of joint venture with Surya Capital Holdings Berhad for the Jasatlin Kuih project on the 21st May 2013. Basically, SBC Corp restructured the payment terms to the Surya Capital Holdings Berhad. Besides, they also stated that their project had been heavily affected by the MCO and they target to complete the project by the end of this year. So, this news shows that SBC Corp quite struggling in their business due to the global COVID-19 pandemic. Now we move to the supply and demand of SBC Corp. Obviously, by this chart, we can see that there is a very low volume for the SBC Corp since the middle of April. On 10 June 2021, the number of volume of SBC Corp is 66,500, while the average volume is 90,900 shares. By this figure, we can understand that the demand for SBC Corp is quite low. In short, we can assume that there is no interest at all in this stock at this moment. For the leader or laggard, there are several companies in the property industry same as SBC Corp, such as MJ Perak, Triven, CVU and G Mutual. In terms of market capital, SBC Corp sits behind G Mutual, CVU, MJ Perak, UP and Huayang. From this chart, we can see that SBC Corp is a laggard company for the past 5 years and we can consider MJ Perak and Triven as the leader of this industry. So technically, any news or catalyst related to the property sector will not heavily impact SBC Corp because it is a laggard company. Next, we take a look at institutional investors in SBC Corporation Berhad. Based on this figure, we can see that LOM Holdings Sdn Bhd currently becomes the top shareholder of SBC Corp with 16 million shares and followed by Sia Tiong Heng, who is the CEO and Managing Director of SBC Corp with 11.99 million shares. The adjusted float of SBC Corporation Berhad is 73.8%, which shows that the amount of retail investor is higher than the institutional investor. We can expect that there are very few institutional investors who invest in this stock. Hence, no truly big institution invest in this company. Last but not least, we go to the market direction of SBC Corp. We take a look at the time frame of 5 years. The highest price reach for the past 5 years was in June 2017. In the long term run, we can see that there is a downtrend pattern. But starting in 2020, SBC Corp seems to attempt to make an uptrend pattern. From this chart also, we can see that there are two long sideways, which are 2018 until the end of 2019 and the middle of 2020 until the early of 2021. In addition also, there is four existing level, which is at 0.765, 0.68, 0.58, and 0.445. Meanwhile, the two support levels are at 0.31 and 0.215. In the middle of 2020, the price broke the support level for a while before it rebound back above the support level, and after that broke the resistance level, which currently a resistance become support level. The resistance level at 0.445 needs to break if SBC Corp wants to make a major uptrend. In brief, the market direction of SBC Corp still slow and no sign that there is a change in trend, so it is not recommended to enter the SBC Corp now. In conclusion, SBC Corp still lacks in many criteria of can sleep and only score at the institutional investor. With the unstable market condition and the property sector itself not indicates a good potential recently, so it is not suitable to invest in SBC Corporation Berhad at this moment. That's all for my can sleep analysis. Thank you.